have this small electric drill and it makes smoke. This is the motor, and if you can see deep in there, the surface that where the brushes make contact, so that's the rotor surface, not the brushes itself. That surface should be copper and should be yellow gold color, and mine it's really like black, almost black. If it's covered like mine, it's dark, looks gray dark, like burnt. You need to clean it up by all means, because that's what makes that flame and smoke, because it cannot make proper electrical contact. So what I'm going to do now, it's simply I'm going to try to reach the rotor, maybe with a Q-tip. I'm not sure if I can do it. I'll try contact cleaner. You may try to spray directly with small amounts on the rotor and just rotate the rotor, but and try to put a droplet of maybe engine oil at the end when you finished over this small shaft, and try to keep it vertical and just let the oil drip, because you are going to dry this kind of bushings. It's not a bearing, it's a bushing here over the shaft. You're going to dry it without solution and you want it to be lubricated, so maybe put a droplet of oil. Let me just try to clean this thing and see if it's I can help it at this point. So now it looks a little bit more shiny, the copper surface. I also did clean the brushes. There was material right in front of the brushes, so I did use a small wire to just scoop all material on all four sides. So there's four sides of the brushes, two on each one. Make sure also the brushes are very, very clean. And let's just give this thing a try. What I found is at first it's better to rotate, spin it slow. If you go fast, it may still make smoke. Perhaps the surface of the rotor has not yet just matching properly the brushes, but maybe try not to put your fingers. It's not big voltage, but anyhow, let's just move it slowly now, and you may still see a tiny spark. That's very normal, a small spark inside. It's okay, but if you see like it's getting like red, like a bubble red or something like this, and making smoke, that's when the problem is. So right now it doesn't make any kind of smoke. I'm not really spinning it fast, but you can go faster. Maybe perhaps not sure if the camera will focus properly, but you can perhaps see a tiny spark that is in there, and that's absolutely normal. That's how the brushes should work. Maybe you'll see it better now perhaps. That tiny spark is absolutely normal, but give it some time to just settle properly against the brushes. Or maybe just repeat it. It depends, obviously. It's going to depend if you clean it really properly, remove all material again. The brushes have two sides on each, but basically two kind of 90 degrees angle with the rotor surface. So you want to clean those edges on both sides of each brushes. So on both sides of the motor, make sure it's really, the idea is to remove the material. Obviously, you may have a situation when either the brushes are worn out, or maybe the rotor is worn out. Mine is still in good condition, has plenty of life to it. But the idea is to remove any kind of material from the rotor surface of and from the brushes, and also to have a rotor surface, the copper surface, that is still not to score, not to burn, not to damage. Actually, I did use my wire and I did kind of scratch gently the rotor surface. Just go gently. Maybe it's going to remove the burn surface layer, the burn material. Go gently, you cannot really damage it. Now normally you would want to remove the rear back cover, but mine it's crimped in four places, like it's four slight bends of this outer shell. It's crimped and it's bent to to keep the cover in place, this part, the round part. Because the metal on my unit is really strong, I just could not unbend these crimps here. You may try to do it, maybe use a cutting pliers, but I can tell you it depends. If you have a quality motor, maybe try to grab it like this and try to rotate it. Watch your hands because you can hurt yourself very easily. But if this outer shell is very strong metal, you won't be able to do it another way. Maybe try to grind it, but it may put metal shavings inside and that may also cause problem. And then if you grind it, those two, four or three crimps, maybe just when you put it back in place, you need just to bend at another place to secure the back plate. Also, when you put it back in place, you need to insert kind of two, maybe like two strong wires. You need to keep the brushes in place expanded so they slide over the rotor, and that's another tricky part. Yeah, the idea, I think it's really to pay attention when you use these kind of drills, no matter the brand. Don't use them in a dusty environment. It's going to work for a while, but then you're going to fall into such problem. Also, no liquids or anything else. If you put a droplet of oil there, put a tiny, tiny droplet of oil. You don't want to leak it, make it leak inside. And other than that, there was someone asking how long would these brushes last. It's difficult to answer such question because you never count basically the time you are using a drill. But I would guess, just a wild, wild guess, maybe at least 50 hours of continuous use, maybe 100 hours, or maybe even more, but it depends also on the material. Some, if you put replacement brushes on, if you have a cheap drill, no brand, a cheap Chinese brand, obviously it's going to have a motor with very weak brushes that may last even maybe 10, 15, 20 hours, and then it's just worn out. By the way, this unit does take a couple of T-Torx T10 screws. It's a rigid unit, so T10, a tiny, tiny Torx. I think there are seven screws, and also has kind of a clamp when you remove the battery. I think it's behind the battery somewhere. It's kind of clamping both covers, so together the front and the rear cover as kind of clips. So you need to look maybe for this kind of clamps right there inside. You just pry it out with a flat screwdriver, just slide it from there to detach the casing. Okay,